Hey students, so now we are going to find out the Fourier expansion of f of x, where f of x has four values. So first value is 0 in minus 2 to minus 1 in this interval. F of x will have value 1 plus x in the interval minus 1 to 0, 1 minus x in the interval 0 to 1, and again 0 in the interval 1 to 2. But guys, if you will see the overall range, it is negative 2 to positive 2. And it reminds me about one type of Fourier series, that is minus L to L. So it means, guys, here I can say that it is minus 2 to 2, means the value of L is equal to 1. So here, first of all, I'll say here L equal to 2. Now guys, since the range is minus L to L, we have to be quite cautious, because whenever we have integration with range minus A to A, there we can use a property of even and odd function. By even and odd function, we can get answer in minimum number of steps. So since it is minus 2 to 2, I'm gonna use, or I'm gonna check the given function f of x, whether it is even or odd. So if we get the given function as even or odd, it becomes easier to get the solution. So let's start, guys. So how to check whether it is even or odd? It's simple, just put x equal to minus x in the function and check what it is giving you in the answer. So let's start. So here f of minus x will be, so it will have four values: 0, 1 minus x, 1 plus x, because x is minus x. So minus x and minus will be plus x, and last one will be 0. Now let's check the range. So minus 2 less than negative x less than negative 1. So guys, this will also change because we are substituting x as minus x everywhere. This will become minus 1 less than minus x less than 0. This will become 0 less than minus x less than 1. This will become 1 less than minus x less than 2. Now to check even an odd function, we have to make these ranges positive. So these four ranges we will change. Now to make it positive, we have to multiply throughout with minus sign, because then only this x will become positive, and then we will compare with the same range. See, because guys, here in this range x is positive, but in this range x is negative. So for the comparison, we should have the positive range in both the functions. So for that, I am multiplying each and every range with negative sign. So this will become positive 2. This less than will become greater than. This minus x will become positive x. Less than will become greater than. Negative 1 will become positive 1. Similarly, minus 1 will become positive 1. Less than will be greater than. Negative x will be positive x. Less than will be greater than. And 0 will be 0. Here 0 as it is. Less than will become greater than. Negative x will become positive x. Less than will become greater than, 1 will become minus 1. And in the end, 1 will become minus 1, then greater than, x greater than, and last value is negative 2. Now guys, let's compare. So here in the range minus 1 to minus 2, the value of f of minus x is 0. Whereas here in minus 1 to minus 2, answer is 0. So it is matching. Next, in 0 comma minus 1, it is 1 plus x. Here also in 0 comma minus 1, answer is 1 plus x. Oh, it is also matching. Now let's check third one. In 0 to 1, answer is 1 minus x. Here also in 0 to 1, answer is 1 minus x. And the last, that is in 1 to 2, we are getting 0. It means, guys, each and every function is matching with the respective intervals. So here we can say in one line that therefore f of negative x is equal to f of x, and therefore the given function f of x is an even function. So therefore f of x is an even function. So here f of x is satisfying the condition, hence that f of x is an even function. And for even function, what we have to do? So we don't have to find out bn, because here I'll show you, in the previous video we did this thing where we assumed f of x as even, and if f of x is even, we know that bn is gonna be 0 straightforward. We don't have to find out bn only. We will find a0 and an by using this formulae which I've written in blue pen. So guys, Here, let's start with the Fourier series. So here we'll say that therefore the Fourier series for an even function f of x is given by f of x equal to a naught plus summation n from 1 to infinity a n cos of n pi x by l. And here we will say since bn is 0, and we will call this as equation number 1. Now guys, let's find out a naught and a n. So the formula for a naught is this, that is 1 by l integration 0 to l f of x dx. And guys, the value of l here we got is 2, so it will be 1 by 2 integration 0 to 2. So here I'll write it down. So a naught is equal to 1 upon 2 integration 0 to 2 f of x dx. Now guys, in the range 0 to 2, this function is divided into two parts, or it is divided into two intervals. One is 0 to 1 and then 1 to 2. So for the interval 0 to 1, f of x is 1 minus x. So here we will get it is equal to 1 by 2 integration 0 to 1, 1 minus x dx. Whereas for interval 1 to 2, the value of f of x is 0. And therefore, we will not write it down because it is going to be 0 in the end. Now, let's start. So, integration of this term is half as it is. Integration of 1 is x minus x square by 2, which is the integration of x from 0 to 1. So, this will give us 1 by 2 as it is. X is 1, so 1 minus 1 by 2. And when I put 0, we will get 0 everywhere. Now 1 minus half is half. So half into half is 1 by 4. And guys, therefore here I write it down that a naught is equal to 1 by 4. Now let's find out an. So an is by the formula, it is 2 upon L. 0 to l f of x cos n pi x by l dx. And guys, l is equal to 2. So it is 2 upon 2, which is 1. So here I'll say integration 0 to 2. 2 upon 2, 1 I will not write. F of x cos of n pi x by l, and l is 2 dx. So now let's evaluate this integration. But again, integration is from 0 to 2, and this range, but this interval is divided into two more intervals. So the first interval is 0 to 1, where f of x is 1 minus x, and second one 1 to 2, where f of x is 0. So I'm not going to consider the second interval because f of x is 0 there. So I'll just consider one interval, that is 0 to 1, and the function is 1 minus x. So guys, this will become integration 0 to 1, 1 minus x cos of n pi x by 2 dx. And guys, we are going to evaluate this integration to get an. So here I'll call this 1 minus x as u and cos as v, because there are two functions multiplying each other. So we are going to use UV rule, and in UV rule we make algebraic function as u, because we are going to use that shortcut formula. So 1 minus x is u and cos is v. So let's start. So an is equal to, in the bracket, first term is 1 minus x, that is u. Then v1, that is integration of this cos term. And the integration of cos is sine. So we will get sine of n pi x upon 2 whole upon n pi by 2. So this is what the value is. Minus derivative of this term. So derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of minus x is minus 1. Next, integration of this term. So integration of sine is minus cos of n pi x by 2 upon n pi by 2. But already we have one more n pi by 2. That will become n square pi square by 4. Now we will not go in the third step because derivative of minus 1 is going to be 0. So here I close the bracket, and the limit is from 0 to 1. So Now let's substitute upper limit, which is 1. So here we will get an as the bracket 1 minus 1 0, so this term will be 0, minus 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 will become minus, this one will come here and that will become cos of n pi by 2, so cos of n pi upon 2 whole upon n square pi square by 4, so n square pi square upon 4. So this is what is the upper limit. Middle sign minus. Now let's put the lower limit, which is 0. So here we will get sine 0, because x is 0, so sine 0 is 0, so first term is 0, minus 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 is minus, cos 0 will be 1 upon n square pi square by 4. Now guys, here an equal to, so from both the terms I can take 1 upon n square pi square by 4 outside, or this 4 will go in the numerator and we will get 4 upon n square pi square common. Now this will become minus minus plus 1, so 1 will remain, and this is negative, that is minus cos of n pi by 2. And guys, this is nothing but the value of an. So we got value of a naught and we got value of an. Now we will put these two values in equation number 1 to get the Fourier series. So guys, here I'll say from equation number 1, by substituting values of a naught and an, f of x is given by, so first of all we'll put the value of a naught, and value of a naught is 1 by 4, so 1 upon 4. Next, an into cos. Now value of an is this, in which 4 and pi square are constants, so I'll take it outside, so plus 4 upon pi square, in the summation from n to n equal to 1 to infinity, we will get 1 minus cos of n pi upon 2 whole upon n square into cos of n pi x by 2. And guys, this is the Fourier series for given function f of x. Thank you very much.